Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We meet once again in a deep informative presentation that I'm praying that once again and one more time, the Holy Spirit is going to give you the knowledge, the wisdom, and the understanding of the word as it will be ministered by the Spirit of Revelation. And I'm still praying that most of you, you develop the hunger for the word. I'm still praying for all of you that you reach a level of understanding that without the word, you are living a dead life. And praying that also I myself, as the Revelator, I'm given the hunger to continue teaching the word, the hunger to continue giving hope, giving courage, giving strength to the souls of God. Today, I want to present a presentation which the Holy Spirit whispered inside my ear, and he said, present the word that heals their flesh. And I'm praying that as I will be ministering this presentation, your flesh is going to be healed from all lusts that are designed to pull you down from the faith of Jesus Christ. Today, I want to talk about the sexual ages. The sexual ages. Oh, yes, you heard me. The sexual ages. And for us to enter an understanding of this presentation, let us get into scriptures. In the book of Romans, chapter 1, verse 18. And in the book of Romans, chapter 1, verse 18, to introduce this presentation, I'll read a scripture. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. Ungodliness and unrighteousness, those two are two dimensions that can be found inside a human being. Ungodliness is not having a relationship with God, and unrighteousness is not playing along in the right standing, principles, guidelines, and rules that create a bond of holiness between you and God. So ungodliness is when you totally don't have a relationship with God, and whatever you are doing, it is not of God, and it leads to unrighteousness, which is a violation of the principles of God, violating the laws of God, the rules and regulations, and you fall into the lust of the flesh. Because that which may be known of God is made manifest in them, for God has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by things that are made. Some of the things that are made, part of the things that are made, it consists of this body that we are carrying. It is part of the evidence of those things which are not seen. The scripture is convincing you to know that everything that has been framed in the practical, in the physical world, it is just evidence of the unseen things. And I'm saying to you as the Revelator, part of the practical things. Before you look at anything material around you, it is your own body, your own flesh. Your own flesh, which is suffering from sexual urges. It is the very same flesh that is being represented by the spirit man. The spirit man was breathed into the nostrils of a physical man, of a void man. And that void man is the void man that is giving you problems through sexual urges. Now, because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. That is humanity being explained there. And professing themselves to be wise, they became fools, and changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to corruptible men. Meaning that there is the glory of the uncorruptible God, who is represented by the uncorruptible man of the spirit. And the uncorruptible man of the spirit is the man that does not lust after the flesh. In the book of Galatians, it explains about the spirit lusting against the flesh and the flesh against the spirit, to the level that these two are contrary against one another. And here the scripture is talking about the glory of the uncorruptible God. And I'm talking about the glory of the uncorruptible man. And the glory of the uncorruptible man is the glory of the spirit man, the man of the spirit, that is not corrupted by the flesh with the sexual urges. Your flesh is suffering from sexual urges not because of any devices around you, but because the flesh itself, it feeds on desires and lusts, not of the spirit. In as much as your spirit feeds on the word, in as much as your spirit feeds on the relationship of righteousness, holiness, and purity with God, your flesh also feeds on lust. So there are devices that represent those lusts. And part of those devices is fornication, adultery, masturbation, sexual imaginations, sexual idolatry. What is sexual idolatry? When you imagine having sex, when you desire having sex, when you continue having sex, when you get addicted to sex, and when you cannot stop having sex, and when you always have sexual urges that drive you to end up having sex, but this whole cycle is when you are not committing sex. What defines this whole cycle is not when you are having sex, but what defines this whole cycle is when you always have sexual urges that don't get fulfilled. The sexual urges that don't get fulfilled, they are a device that is caused by the flesh, which is the corruptible man. The corruptible man. The man that is corrupted. The man that has been corrupted by the virus of the flesh. The man that has been corrupted by the visuals that is watching. Anything that you are going to find yourself watching that corrupts your mind is also going to corrupt your flesh.
and mercy.
You could be secretly watching pornography, and your worry is that no one should find out that you're watching such sensitive sexual content. You could be masturbating, and your only worry is that your wife must not find out, or your husband must not find out. You could be masturbating also as a single person. But what you don't realize is that you are feeding the man of the flesh. You are trying to fulfill or satisfy yourself. You are trying to get rid of those sexual urges using the wrong solutions. What is happening is that whilst you are watching pornography, you are actually enhancing the hunger of the sexual urges inside the flesh. There are sexual demons that are very tactical. They will encourage you to continue having sex so that you fulfill the desires of the flesh. But whilst you continue having sex, you don't realize that you are enhancing the sexual urges to become worse than before. There are sexual demons that are very tactical. They will destroy your sexual life in marriage. You will not even have feelings for sex until your wife goes for menstrual cycle. Why is that done? So that you start searching for sex elsewhere, through another portal that invites more sexual demons, through another portal that invites more lustful desires that captivate this flesh. There are sexual demons that are tactical. They will make you read novels, Mills and Booms novels, that corrupt your mind. And when your mind is corrupted, you end up rubbing your clit, or you end up fingering yourself. And whilst you are fingering yourself, you are believing that you are satisfying yourself from the cravings of sex that are haunting you. You are making yourself believe that you are trying to fulfill the desires of the or the fantasies of the contents that you are reading. But you are actually adding, or you are enhancing, the lust of the flesh. The sexual urges, they become more critical. Why? Because as you were committing fornication, you were feeding that sex demon. It gains more power. It gains a momentum in the spirit to continue haunting you. And when you continue being haunted, you become a slave, not only of sin, but a slave of sexual urges. In Romans chapter 1, verse 24, wherefore God also gave them up to uncleanness through the lust of their own heart. When you hear the scripture says God gave them up, it means God had realized what was inside their hearts. There's a level when God gives you up. But God does not just give you up for no reason. He gives you up after realizing that you are still lusting for the world. God knows the desires of your heart. If there is one being that you cannot fool, it is God. He knows exactly what you need. Even while the Revelator is counseling you, teaching you to abstain from sex, to abstain from fornication, abstain from adultery, abstain from masturbation, God knows what you need. And God knows that you want sex, you want to fornicate. And in Romans chapter 1, verse 24, the people that are being defined here, they were given up by God because of the uncleanness through the lust of their own hearts to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. How were these men dishonoring their bodies between themselves? They had undying cravings inside their sexual urges. They were craving for sex to the level that they could not hear the voice of God. They were craving for sex to the level that they could not tolerate the word of God. They were craving for sex. They had sexual urges that would not allow them to even hear a word that is coming from God. And then God gave them up to vile affections, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. Between themselves. What does the scripture mean when the scripture is saying between themselves? It means between themselves, the spirit and the body. The flesh started lusting against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh, and there was a contradiction inside the body. There was a warfare inside the flesh. They started lusting for sex. They started craving to the level that even men became intimate with men, and if women became intimate with women. Who changed the truth of God in Romans chapter 1 verse 25? Who changed the truth of God into a lie and worshipped and served the creature more than the creator? Which creature? The flesh. The creature is the flesh, and the spirit is a God. Why? Because it carries the image and the likeness of a God. And when you worship the creature, you are not only idolizing anything that is around, you are now idolizing your own flesh. Why? Because your sexual urges have taken you to the level of not even heeding to the instructions of God. All you think about is sex from morning to evening. You are watching pornography. You are reading books, novels of sexual intimacy. Everything that just rings your head is sex, nothing else. And after you have reached that corrupted level, you are heading for destruction. For this cause, God then gave them up to vile affections. For even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. That which is against nature is that which is against the nature of the spirit man. There's the nature of the spirit man, and there's the nature of sin. The nature of the spirit man is the nature against sin, and the nature of sin goes against the nature of the spirit man, which is against sin. And likewise, also men living the natural use of the woman pent in their lust towards another man and working that which unseemingly and receiving in themselves the era and the error which was meet. And as they did not allow themselves to realize God. Child of God, I want to pray for you. If you are struggling from whatever sexual urges, could it be masturbation? You are struggling with fornication. You are struggling with adultery. You are struggling with self-control. I want to pray for you wherever you are right now, so that you are given the spirit of self-control. You are given the spirit to be able to manage your body. You are able to abstain from sex. You are able to say no. When any device, when any agent of the devil wants to lure you into any sexual temptation, I'm praying for you so that you conquer in the name of Jesus.
I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us so. Oh.